Hi everyone, welcome to Be Smart Together. Please click subscribe and turn on the notification to avoid missing valuable videos. Also, feel free to drop a comment or any Power Query questions. I am keen to share my Power Query's Excel modeling knowledge with you. I am sure you would have run into some roadblocks when you use Power Query for most of you. For instance, you imported an Excel file, and the next time you tried to refresh the query, you got an error like the source file moved. Usually, you go to the data source settings, change source, and browse for the source file. You thought this would have fixed the error. But the worksheet name changed. I have good news for you. I will show you how to handle the challenge. Let's create an input table. The first column is file path and the second one is worksheet name. To get the file, you need to go to the File Explorer, right-click on the source file, and select Properties. Then, go to the Security tab and copy the object name. Go back to the spreadsheet and paste it to the cell right below file path. The worksheet name is Sales. Now, we need to import this input table into Power Query. Change the query name to source path. Then, expand the query pane. Copy the source path query, and paste it right below. Then rename it to worksheet name. These queries will be a variable input to the main query. The first step to turning them into a variable input is to right-click on the worksheet name, then select drill down. Now go to the source path query and do the same thing. Go to the sales 2018 query. Click on the go to error. We want to replace the sales 2018 in the formula bar with worksheet name. Go to the source step. Replace the file path in the formula bar with source path. Close and load to Excel. It loaded with no error. Here is another challenge. What if source file constantly moving between local drive and SharePoint? Let me show you how to handle it. Let's import an example file from SharePoint. We need to go to SharePoint folder where the source file saved for the URL. Select the source file then click on the detail pane. Scroll down to the very bottom. Click here to copy the direct link. Go back to Excel and paste it the URL field. The URL contains a percentage sign and the number 20. We need to replace them with space. Replace all of them, then click OK to continue. Go to the organizational account for SharePoint, and sign in. Then, click Connect. Now, we import and transform the data as per usual. Hang on. Do we need to transform the data again? No, we are trying to get the code. Expand the query pane, then go to the source step. We want to replace the URL with source path. Now we have the code for importing from SharePoint. Copy the code, go to the sales 2018 query, and then go to the source step. All you need to do is paste over the copied code if you intend to change the query from import from the local drive to SharePoint. Let's undo it. What we want to do is have the query handle both import methods. Click to add a manual step, and paste over the copied code. Rename the custom one step to source one. Let's add one more custom step. Type in try source otherwise source one. Then rename the step to conditional source. Finally, let's load it to Excel and see the result. Let's update the file path in the input table to SharePoint URL for the test run. We need to replace the percentage sign and the number 20 with space. Now is the most important moment. Let us refresh the query. Let's speed up. Hooray! It works. Thank you for watching, and I hope you find this video helpful. Please don't forget to click like if you liked the video.